Hi guys, Will here. Great to see all you maniacs back on the channel. Before I start, I just wanted to make mention that this video was previously uploaded on my second channel, Audits Exposed. Please take the opportunity to go and subscribe, have a look at some of the videos I have over there, because I'm spending a lot of time on that channel, and pretty soon we're going to have our first live stream. With that out of the way, enjoy the video. All right, so today we're going to have a look at one of our First Amendment auditor friends that's out filming the police in a situation that it appears he doesn't know much about. But let's look objectively and see if we can analyze whether or not this is a proper example of filming the police lawfully. Let's have a look.
Must be a busy day, huh? Must be a busy day. You all right, sir?
Yeah.
What are they stopping you for?
Red light, I guess.
Stop. You don't need to come any closer.
Are they writing you a ticket?
Yeah, I think so. I don't know. I think they're just giving me a new coordinator or something like that. It's been all right to me. It's been fine.
So I find it interesting that one of the common arguments that these auditors make is that they're filming the police is not filming the police itself, but for the safety and protection of the person being investigated by the police. In this case, the person being investigated by the police said there wasn't a problem, said the police were treating him well, and he was in the wrong. So therefore, any fear or concern that this citizen had should be diffused at this point. Now that doesn't negate his right of filming, it just negates his right of concern or fear. So therefore he cannot say that I'm filming for this person's safety and protection, more I'm filming for my own personal interests.
You okay?
Yeah.
Cool. Do you know which one of these actually stopped you?
It's not here actually. I'm not sure.
Okay.
I wasn't really stopped. I
already
had to stop the light and stuff. They just sent me a coordinator or whatever.
Sounds good. Make sure you get all of their business cards, okay? So you know exactly who's.
Oh, yes.
Who you need to call the court.
Right on.
In case the wrong one shows up, because they like doing that.
Wow.
Yeah, since they're all involved. When you go to your court,
okay.
All right. If you whatever you decide to do,
right,
make sure they're all there,
right,
and get their body cams too. You see, they all got body cams.
Yeah.
Make sure none of that is missing.
How do I do that?
Public request. Okay. Public records request.
All right.
And because you're a defendant, a lot of times that's discovery. Probably either free or minimum fee.
I don't think it's that hardcore. But thank you, I really appreciate it.
Of course.
Dave being like hardcore.
Yeah, I don't know what the deal is.
I guess they should have ran a red light or something. But I'm here, it's close. I was pushing the yellow on it, so maybe.
You were on the bike?
Yeah.
I find it interesting that Mr. Kitty Cat's objective in posting this video is displaying some form of corruption by the police. But in this instance, if you notice, the police allow him to engage with this individuals for almost 2 minutes at this point, completely uninterrupted. So I don't see any violations of anyone's rights here. If anything, the police are allowing him to film and ask the person being investigated questions.
Thank you. line and you go around doing this? That's pretty cool.
No, I don't have free time. I'm taking time off work.
Wow, that's awesome.
To look out for my fellow Americans.
That's what's up. Very cool.
Yeah.
6'2".
You know how they are, right? They say they're here to serve public, but...
There could be some bad ones, yes, sir.
That's right. So...
That's awesome. Oh, definitely. Yeah, thank you.
And you see, my record stays with me.
Right.
They? You try to request the record, and it disappears.
Wow.
It disappears magically, right? Because they need to get you.
Wow.
So, you didn't answer any other questions, right? Don't answer any questions.
Sir.
Don't give them anything.
So this is where the controversy arises, and this is what these auditors seem to always do where they mess up. And that is, they are obstructing the police in the course of their duties. The law is very clear in that, yes, physically a person can obstruct. Obstructing can be classified as a physical act. But the point is, if the person is intentionally impairing or perverting the administration of law in any way, shape, or form, or any manner, it's not just limited to a physical act. So therefore, yes, by trying to bark directives at the person being detained by the police, contrary to what the police is telling him to do, that is obstruction. And as we see, is a misdemeanor in the second degree, which is a crime.
Say,
you can film, but
if you're going to interfere with me, buddy boy,
you're
going to learn real quick. You're going to learn real quick. If you're going to interfere with my First Amendment, you are going to learn real quick, buddy boy. Got that?
Tell him what he needs to do.
You are going to learn real quick. So you better take your ass to where you need to be. You don't give me directions.
Now you're starting to
You can piss off. I can stand where the hell I want.
Sir.
My freedom of speech is not interference. I can say whatever the hell I choose to. You're going to piss me off? Buddy boy, you're going to learn.
You're
going
to
learn.
Making this into something it doesn't need to be.
I don't give a damn what you think. Okay. I don't give a damn what you're saying. You're going to interfere with my First Amendment. You're going to learn.
I just don't want you interfering.
Get the hell out of my way.
No.
Right now, you're committing a federal crime. Okay. You understand?
No, I can.
You're committing a federal crime.
You can.
Do you know what that crime is?
I'm not committing a federal crime.
You are. Because when you're blocking my camera and my First Amendment rights,
you can stand over there and film if you want.
You don't tell me where to stand.
Okay.
You got that? You don't tell me where to stand.
Now, this is a common ploy by these auditors to insinuate that there will be some form of repercussions to this officer for simply asking him to step back and not interfere with his traffic stop or whatever the investigation is. Now, the auditor doesn't say specifically what those repercussions are, but I can assume he's talking about the officer losing their qualified immunity, which is something that they commonly say. So I think it's good to stop for a moment and ask, what exactly is qualified immunity? Qualified immunity, in essence, is protection that protects some form of a government official or police officer from frivolous lawsuits from individuals claiming that their rights, quote unquote, were violated. Now, the burden is on the person filing the suit to prove that the officials violated what's called a clearly established constitutional right. Now, this stems from the case Pearson v. Callahan, which is a very interesting case from 2009, where it really defines what they're looking for when the topic or the subject of qualified immunity is argued. And I'm going to read word for word from the case. Qualified immunity balances two important interests: the need to hold public officials accountable when they exercise power irresponsibly, and the need to shield officials from harassment, distraction, and liability when they perform their duties reasonably. Saucere, which is another case reference in this case, mandated a two-step sequence for resolving government officials' qualified immunity claims. A court must decide, 1, whether the facts alleged or shown by the plaintiff make out a violation of a constitutional right, and 2, if so, whether that right was clearly established at the time of the defendant's alleged misconduct. Qualified immunity applies unless the official's conduct violates such a right. So here's a question, and I asked this question with a lot of these videos. Was it clearly established that, in this case specifically, the officer violated this auditor's rights by telling him not to interfere with the traffic stop? And the answer is no, because it's not established that it was a violation of his rights, because again, it is a crime to interfere with the police when they are investigating a matter, and the right of free speech and of a person's conduct is not unfettered. Yes, the officers gave him much leniency, but at the end of the day, he took it a step too far, and the officer was in his right to tell him not to interfere. Therefore, his claims of the officer going to be in trouble, his repercussions for his actions are 100% false.
You don't tell me where to stand.
You can keep yelling at me, but I'm
get the hell out of my way.
I'm not going to get out of your way.
Yes, you will.
No, I won't.
Yes, you will.
Not at this point. You can go stand over there and do it.
You don't tell me what I need to do or not to do. Got it? I'm a free person. I was engaged in freedom of speech, and I was engaged in freedom of press.
You've already been interfering earlier today with what we're
doing. How?
I'm not going to go over that first stop over there, but you know what you're doing.
What was I doing?
And that guy was asking you not to film.
What was I doing?
Okay. I'm going to
what?
I'm talking to you.
Exactly, because it's not interfering.
No, it's just because it's...
Did you hear that?
No, I didn't hear what he said.
No expectation of privacy in public,
I'm not
and my freedom of speech is not interference.
You can take off.
You all right?
Yeah, thank you.
Okay.
Much.
Pieces of trash. Piss off! You're gonna give me your directives over here. And you will learn once I upload it again.
Oh, you're gonna learn if you keep pushing.
Yeah. Do it. See what you got. Because I'm not running.
Well, I think we can agree that this is yet again another audit fail, because the officers were more than lenient in allowing him to engage with the individual. And I think maybe that was definitely a bit of a stretch, but it's up to the officer's discretion. But despite that, the auditor couldn't help himself by trying to take it a step further by interfering with lawful directives from the police officer, which is a crime. Well, that's my two cents for the day. Hopefully these auditors will realize that yes, filming the police is a right. Interfering with the police stop is not. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video, and hey, see you guys next time.